HoloNet audio dramas is something that I have been wanting to do for a very long time. What it is really a collection of quality narrated Star Wars fan fiction with music and some sound effects, and it's geared toward, well, two audiences. Number one, anyone that really enjoys that kind of audio entertainment, but number two, and perhaps more primarily, visually impaired fans of Star Wars. People that can't read, people that really can't appreciate fan fiction as we read it on the internet and elsewhere, unless someone reads it to them, and this is exactly what that is. It's Star Wars fan fiction in an audiobook-style presentation, and they can listen to it on our website, holonetaudiodramas.com, or also from an audio CD that we offer. People have to do is email me at darkempireradio@aim.com, and if they want an audio CD, and I'd be happy to send them one. We encourage them to donate to help offset the cost of shipping and materials. But that's not a requirement. I'd be happy to send a CD out to anyone that wants one. Well, the purpose of the HNAD project is to do two things. Number one, entertain people, but also to promote literacy. And people say, well, why call it HNAD? I mean, HoloNet audio drama is okay, but HNAD sounds like a disease. Well, in a sense, I think we can all agree that illiteracy is a disease, and it is rapidly spreading. And the antidote to that disease, the antidote to illiteracy, is literacy. I figured, why not do that? Get people to want to write. If they want to submit something for HoloNet audio dramas, or just to write for the fun of it, or whatever, let your creative imagination flow from your pen, or just pick up a book and read. You know, if you enjoy, or just listen to this project, I think that is the most important mission of the HNAD project. But to bring fan fiction to those that can't see or can't read, and to entertain them, and also to promote literacy to a certain degree, I really think that that's the uniqueness of this project, that not only is it fun, but it's a win-win situation. There is literally no money involved. We don't take a profit of any kind. We'll take donations to help offset the costs of CDs and materials, shipping if we send a CD out. But that's really it. You know, it is a project that, it's in its simplicity, I think, is something that speaks volumes. Well, I was really inspired to do the HNAD project after years of doing podcasting and making silly videos on YouTube now and then, and of course doing voiceover work here and there. And I realized that maybe I can do something with my voice and make it more useful and do something, give back to the community like this. The HoloNet Audio Dramas project stems from Dark Empire Radio, which is a podcast I've done for a few years, and I've done fan fiction on there for a few years, and I've decided to expand that to make sure that people are actually listening to it, not just listening to the podcast, but for people that really have a desire to enjoy really good storytelling and really good Star Wars material that they don't find in books and things like that. And it's fan-produced and fan-written, and I think very much fan-enjoyed. At one event at a library not too long ago, the Dark Empire Costume Club had a table, and of course I had about 30 HoloNet audio dramas CDs there. In fact, it was the first time we had CDs at a table at an event. And what happened was, is that when I started telling people about the project, you know, word got out and people started wanting CDs. Before long, there was one lady in particular who was brought to the TDE table. That's the Dark Empire table. And we had things on display there that were all dark side related. There was a Sith holocron. There was a lightsaber. And her husband, or her helper, I don't know if it was her husband or who it was, but he was guiding her hand ever so gently on some of the props that we had. And of course, we had a great big sign that said, please do not touch. But in this case, it was okay. I had absolutely no problem with it. He was guiding her hand along, and he said, this is a lightsaber. And he let her touch it along the hilt. And She was, I could tell by the expression on her face that she was kind of trying to imagine what the lightsaber looked like. And I could tell by looking at her face that she was enjoying the experience. Ooh, this is a lightsaber. This is not some plastic toy. This is a real quality prop. And right away, I knew that they were Star Wars fans because they both knew what the props were. He put her hand on this really nice holocron prop that was on the table, and he said, "This is a Sith holocron," and he let her feel that. And she was, I could tell again by looking at her face that she was taking it all in, trying to imagine in her mind what this prop looked like. And of course, I had this stack of CDs on the table, and I looked at the others that were with me and back at her, and right away I said, "Are you a fan of Star Wars?" And she said, "Well, yes." And then I told her about the HoloNet Audio Dramas project and what the CDs that were there were for. And then I said, "They're for visually impaired fans of Star Wars and really anyone that appreciates Star Wars fan fiction. And this is a way to bring it to people that don't have a way of reading it." And I said, "Would you like a CD?" And her face just lit up. And she said, "Yes, I would love one." And so I gave her a CD, and she was immensely thankful. And that was a three-hour event. And at the end of the three-hour event, we had no CDs left. And I knew right then and there that this project meant something. The ultimate goal for the HoloNet Audio Dramas project is to transition from CDs to preloaded MP3 players. Right now, we have one CD volume ready. It has 9 tracks on it, and it has about almost 2 hours of storytelling on it, all set to music and everything. And I'm working on a second volume now. The more tracks that I put up on my SoundCloud account and thusly on the HoloNet Audio Dramas page, then the more CDs will become available, CD volumes. Ultimately, once we have 30, 40, or 50 or more tracks done, I'd like to transition from CDs to preloaded MP3 players, and we'll probably start some kind of a Kickstarter or similar type campaign when we're ready to do that. And we'll be, instead of distributing CDs to people, we'll be distributing MP3 players preloaded with HoloNet Audio Dramas content. And that would be a lot of fun. Of course, just giving the CDs away, of course, is also a lot of fun. And narrating them is a lot of fun. The CDs themselves are, of course, signed by me, and one day we'll have a CD label. But in the meantime, I'm having a lot of fun recording the CDs, signing them, and handing them out to anyone that appreciates that kind of entertainment. And of course, to visually impaired fans of Star Wars. HoloNet Audio Dramas can be found at holonetaudiodramas.com, and also the fan fiction that's on the HNAD project is also on Dark Empire Radio, a podcast which can be found at thedarkempire.org, as well as on iTunes. It's under podcasts. Just look for Dark Empire Radio. All of the fan fiction that is on HoloNet Audio Dramas is also on Dark Empire Radio.